And good afternoon, YouTube. So this is my main bench grinder, or I have it on a pedestal here. And when I first got this grinder, it was extremely smooth and quiet. And now it's gotten a little bit noisier. So let me flip it on here. That's part of the problem here is that this coarse grinding wheel got a little bit out of round, so I've been trying to true it back up again. This one had actually loosened up, but I think all of these things are actually symptoms of the real problem. And you can see right here, there's a slight bit of movement in the two bolts I used to hold it down to the pedestal. They just barely move, but I think what's happened is there must be a couple of screws or bolts up through the base into the motor housing, and that's where the motion is. You can see it's right there. So this whole thing is loose, and I think it was that vibration caused the nut holding the horse wheel to loosen up, and then that caused this wheel to get out around, which made the vibration worse. And it just got to the point where it was really bad. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug this, take out the two bolts that hold it down to the pedestal, and then see if I can find the bolts that go up into the motor. And while I'm there, this grinder has a nice light on it. I put an LED bulb in here because they seem to handle the vibration a lot better. I used to put a filament bulb, even a heavy-duty filament bulb, and the vibration of the grinder would break the filament when it was on. So I really like this light. You know, you can move it down, put it down so you can see what you're grinding. But I would like to have this light controlled by that switch, because every time you turn on the grinder, then you got to turn on the light. And then you turn the grinder off, you turn the light off. So if I can get onto the wires from that switch, I want to run the wires for the light through that bottom switch. Okay, got the grinder off the pedestal, and then you have to take the four rubber feet off, and that holds this cover panel in place. There's a screw here, and I bet there's the other screw underneath the capacitor there. So let's see if we can take that out. I've got the thing unplugged. You can see those screws are loose there. So while we're in here, the lamp goes out this wire loom here. Here's your green ground. It's a little bit complicated. The switch was throwing me for a while because it's got three terminals. And if you follow here, here's the hot incoming black, and then it goes over to the light. And then there's two red wires, so one red wire goes to the bottom terminal of the switch, and the other one goes into the motor. And then here's the neutral, so you got the white coming in, the white going to the light, and then there's a red going to the top of the switch. So the center terminal must be the power to the motor. I think that's the key here, because this switch, there's a little isolation piece right there, and your hot wire is on the bottom. I've got my continuity beeper on, and then I'll flip the switch. There's the switched output, and then there's the line or hot wire for the neon. So I still want that on the top, but this one is the one that goes into the motor. So I think what I'll do is I'll make up a male to go in there, and then I'll clip the neutral that goes into the light, cut that loose. I'll put two wires into a female that goes on here. One of them will be this wire, and then I'll add a little pigtail to pick up this wire. Okay, YouTube, got a little bit of work done on this last night. What I did was took the base off here, both screws. So then I cleaned up the paint with some acetone. So then I ran a bead of adhesive around where the base contacts the motor. and then put the two screws in here with some red Loctite, and they look like they're M6 screws. So if the Phillips head screws don't hold, I'll try to replace them. I think a hex head would be a lot better in here. I just didn't have any of those on hand, or I would have used them. So the idea with this adhesive, I used some Shoe Goo, which is kind of a rubbery adhesive, and I'm thinking that'll help kind of stick these together, but also provide some vibration dampening, so that if there is some vibration, the adhesive will hold the thing together so it doesn't start moving around. But we'll see. I figure I would try something a little different. And then let's go take a look at the wiring here. Anyway, got the motor capacitor back in there since it's okay. Got that screw. Did I get that tight? Oh, I didn't tighten that up all the way. And then what I did was I cut the white neutral wire off of the light here, and I put that into a female spade lug, and I'm going to slide that onto the middle terminal of the switch here. See how that fits. That looks like it's okay. And then this is the wire that came off the middle terminal, and I put a male spade lug there, and this is where I cut the neutral that fed the light off. So this is the neutral coming in. That feeds one end of the switch. The hot is on the other end of the switch for the neon indicator. And then this is the switch to neutral, which now goes to the gooseneck light. So now the light should turn on and off with the grinder. And then the switch on the light, if I don't need a light, I can turn it off. Yeah, so basically I just took this neutral connection here on the light and I moved it over here, so it's on the switch side instead of the unswitched. A pretty simple change, just one jumper wire there. So yeah, let me get the bottom back on this. We'll get the cover and the base back on and then get it bolted back to the stand, and then we can try it out. Okay, YouTube, let's give it a test. I've got the light switch turned on, so if I turn on the grinder, the light comes on. Turn it off. You can see how the light fades out. Okay, and there we're coasting to a stop. Still have a little work to do to get this wheel trued back up. Yeah, this side's okay, but it was this side. The loose screws caused this to vibrate, and then the vibration caused the nut to loosen, and then that caused this wheel to wear a little crooked. So I've got a bit of work to get that trued up again. But yeah, the light turns on and off when you turn the grinder on and off. And you notice how the light dimmed slowly when I turned the power off, because the motor is still spinning and generating a little bit of power. I guess the back EMF was enough to keep the light bulb running for a bit. I guess I should have got in there and fixed it a little earlier before this wheel loosened up. So this was a Sunex Tools model 5002A. 8-inch diameter, 1-inch wide wheel on both sides. Yeah, so now I have a light that turns on and off with the grinder. Have one of these grinders with a built-in gooseneck light. Pretty easy to rewire it to have the light turn on and off with the grinder motor. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put some other power tool repair videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.